I do have time, okay. Because I have a habit of not turning it on other days. Good morning.
Good morning.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
I asked someone who says, what is that white stuff outside? And she said it's California snow. Which means it'll melt pretty quickly. But anyway, but it's nice again. Unfortunately, you don't have the view that I have. I can look out those windows and see the snow on the mountains. How many of you appreciate that the snow is on the mountains? That's what I thought. It's there, it's not here. I understand. Okay, anyway. Well, Happy New Year, and good to have you with us. This is the Sunday of Epiphany. We hold on to Christmas a little bit. So as I was thinking about that, we talked about the 12 days of Christmas, which actually ended yesterday. So we're extending Christmas one more day. And so this would be the 13th day of Christmas. And that doesn't sound right, because that's not a lucky number. So this will be the 14th day of Christmas. On the 14th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a chance to celebrate Epiphany.
Wow!
It took me weeks to figure out. Anyway, so that's what we're celebrating this morning. So good to have you with us. And we've even got some magi that are going to show up and help us sing this morning, too. So we're happy for that. We begin with our gathering song this morning. So I invite you to stand as you are able, and we will sing Bright and Glorious is the Sky. Have mercy on us, where restore our trust. Renew us with your grace, and give us again the hope of eternal life in you. Amen. Hear the good news. We are children of God and heirs of God's promises through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven and redeemed. Sing with joy, all the ends of the earth shall know the salvation of God. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Our song of praise this morning is We Three Kings of Orient Are, and we happen to have three wise people here. It was a stretch, but I found three. We did. And all of them were in the choir. I said, who would know, right? Anyway. So as we sing We Three Kings, as a congregation, we're going to sing the first verse. And our three kings are going to sing verses 2, 3, and 4. We're going to sing the refrain on those ones, and then we'll all sing verse 5 together. So let us sing together We Three Kings of Orient Are.
Thank you.
just to let you know that. So the wise people could have been men or women. That's why we had some men and women. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray together in the prayer of the day. O God, on this day, you revealed your Son to the nations by the leading of a star. Lead us now by faith to know your presence in our lives, and bring us at last to the full vision of your glory, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And now we have our special music. Thank you very much. As we begin the season of Epiphany, our theme this morning is looking for the stars. And so as I was doing this and I was doing my Google search there, I heard a wonderful song, and it was an instrumental song by Michael W. Smith. And it was called The Stars. And I said, well, this is wonderful, so I can put maybe some pictures of stars while this music's playing. Well, as I continued to do some search, I found this wonderful, wonderful song. It's about 6 years old. It's from Michael W. Smith, and it's called A Million Lights. And so I thought, this is perfect for today. So our epiphany moment for today, which is our enlightened moment, you might say, when we see the light of Christ, is we're going to watch this video that's called A Million Lights. Wait a minute, this cannot be. Because Because what happens after this story, some of you probably know this, but King Herod decided to do what? Kill all the firstborn sons from 2 ages and younger. So this also tells us that this story could take place anywhere between Jesus' birth and being 2 years old. Because it says they go to the house and found the child. Probably closer to 2. But that's King Herod. Everyone was frightened. They were afraid at this time because of what the king was dealing with. So these magi who are traveling for so long, following the stars, looking for direction, maybe looking for new life, maybe looking for new possibilities, because that's why they were there. That's why they were there. Today, we look to the stars. In fact, there's a whole lot of people that are really into astrology and horoscopes. You don't have to raise your hand if you don't want to, but how many of you look at your horoscope on a daily basis? There are some people who do that, right? Yeah. And you kind of look at it and go, yeah, right, you know. Especially if it says you're going to run into someone with lots of money and give it to you. You're going to, yeah, right, you know. Well, some people look at their horoscopes. And also what they do is they plan their day around it. Oh, something's going to happen today, so I'm not going to buy the house. You know, something's going to happen today, but that's when they become afraid. They look for meaning in this horoscope as if that's going to really focus in on their day. And sometimes psychologically, if we read something, we might believe it. And our day might be focused on that rather than what God has given to us. What am I going to do today? Look to the stars. What do you see? What do you see when you see the stars? Especially on a night that you can see billions and billions of stars, you might say, when there's no moon, when there's no streetlights, when there's no lights in the city. You see billions and billions of lights. Light years away, these stars are. And every time we sit there and we look at those stars, we think of the endlessness of creation. The endlessness of it all. It doesn't end. It just keeps going. For eternity, you might say. And it reminds us in a small way of the endlessness of God's love. That God created all of this. That God created us and the solar system that we live in, the sun, everything is done perfectly. Everything is in order so that we can live. Look to the stars. What are we searching for as we begin this new year? A lot of us are searching for direction. What's going to happen this year? What's God going to do? What should I be doing? We're searching for direction. We're looking to the stars. We're looking for new possibilities. Maybe recently retired or got a new job or some new things, or new grandkids or great grandkids along the way. It's just one of the new possibilities, the new life here that God has given to us in this new year. Look to the stars. Look at the endlessness of God's love for you. The search of the Magi. Think about it. The search of the Magi. It began and it ended with Jesus. It began when they saw the star, and they knew they were going to go to the Messiah, and as soon as they see Jesus, it ended there. Simeon and Anna, that we celebrated and got to know a little bit last Sunday, their story also began and ended with Jesus. As soon as Simeon sees Jesus, he lifts up and says, okay, now I can die or die. I've seen God's salvation. Anna, who's been praying and thinking about this every day of her life, it ends with Jesus saying, okay, now I know that God's word is true. Look to the stars. What do you see? Are you looking for new possibilities? You're looking for new life? You're looking for direction? It begins and it ends with Jesus. Focus in on the love of God. Jesus. That's what the story is about today. That's what Epiphany is all about. A revealing of Jesus. That's where we start. That Jesus is revealed to us through all parts of creation. And so today, remember these words from Isaiah. for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. In Bible study, it's hard. I'm going to take a look at Isaiah and just kind of pull it apart a little bit. But as Marlene was reading that today, what occurred to me was the word you and your. This is your light. This is your salvation. This is your God. And the people of the world will come to your light. We are the light of Christ. Let us continue to live and to love and to see the endlessness of God's love and creation as we look to the stars, as we look to Jesus, as we look to each other. Let us celebrate life because it reminds us that God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Let us sing our serving hymn, Advent's Gladness, Men and Women. And schools and other places. And so we just need to continue to pray for peace. And talk about the ceasefire, of course, we focus in on Israel, Palestine, Ukraine, but also just a ceasefire within our own communities. The number of gun violence that just continues to be part of our news, unfortunately. So let us pray for that today, and pray for the victims of that.
Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
And today, Lord, as we look to the stars, we thank you for your grace and your peace, which you shower upon us each and every day. So we thank you for the endlessness of your love, as you've given us signs in the sky and signs in our hearts of your grace. And Lord, today, as we thank you for your grace, we ask for your grace, your healing, your power to be with these who need you in a special way. And today, we especially lift up and pray for Berlette, Frida, Marion, Harriet, Don, Ann, Tommy, Grace, Barbara, Jonna, Janet, Sharon, Lois, Carol, Marcia, Doris, Pony, Janet, Kelly, Janet, Daryl, Dennis, Ginny, Pat, Pastor Megan, and our husband Bobby, and their family. And those we mentioned in our hearts at this time. Lord God, we also lift up the prayer for Cindy Parcelli. Prayers for a good recovery during her rehab. We thank you that your presence has been with her too. Lord God, as we pray for these people, we thank you for your presence with them. And may you continue to reveal yourself to them. And we pray for not only them, but for their family members, their caregivers, for doctors and nurses, for all those who are providing your healing touch to these your people. Lord God, we thank you that in the midst of life, you continue to walk with us, even through the valley of the shadow of death. Hear us, O God. Abide with us, O God of mercy, and receive all of our prayers according to your abundant grace. As we continue to pray, we also lift up Debbie Fiedler, who is celebrating her birthday today. So we thank you for these gifts of life, for the gifts of the stars, for the gift of our heartbeats, for the gift of our breath. As we give thanks to you, we give thanks for the Christ child that is born, and may that Christ child be born in our hearts each and every day as we lift up our prayers to you. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Please stand and greet those around you with the peace of the Lord as much as you're comfortable. Thank you. Let us pray together the offering. God of blessings, receive and bless these gifts we have offered. Join our hearts with the song of the angels, and gather us at your table of celebration. Strengthen us to share with all the world the abundance of your grace upon grace, poured out in Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh. Amen. Before we move to the time of communion, I want to share something with you. On the two tables that are sitting here, as you go back to your seats, I invite you to pick up a card, and on this card, they're called Star Words, not Star Wars, Star Words. And it's interesting, because I was looking back there, I think, and I don't know how many years ago this was, and this is kind of a little test, so you can do this, but I think Pastor Terry Tooney Allen was here, and he did Star Wars. How many years ago was that?
Four.
Okay. That's what I figured. And so what you're invited to do is to pick up one of those cards, and now there's a word. And so for this next year, put that somewhere that you might see it every day to think about that word. To think how we might live into that word. And so they're called Star Words. And so we share that at the beginning of the year. And so if you take one of those now, there's one thing that I ask people to do is, if you pick up one you don't like it, you can't put it down and take another one. No, that's your word, okay? And if you have a chance, if you think about it, if you look through it, I'm not sure about this, then you may call or send an email and say, no, I'm trying to figure this out. And so maybe together we can figure it out. And then also share your word with other people. You know, when you're in coffee today or something, well, what did you get? And see how you can start to live into what that word is. So as you come forward for communion, as you go back to your seats, you can place your little cups there, but take one of those on either table. And either table is about the same. You don't have to go up this side and worship over there and take another. No, just take one card and one purpose. And we have lived into this next year with our Star Words for this year. Here's this invitation to communion. Friends, we know what it feels like to look for God. We know what it feels like when he turns our heads to the stars, looking for stars, listening for a voice that calls us beloved. I think that's why, part of why we end up here, because we're hoping that in the midst of this messy world, we might catch a glimpse of God that will carry us through. Well, friends, I've got good news. God is already here. Like a mighty wind, God is moving through this room. God is at this table inviting us forward. Now the invitation might not be as clear as the stars in the sky or a voice that parts the clouds, but just as God that called Jesus beloved, God calls you the same. So come to this table with your questions and with your doubts. Come with your joys and your gratitude. Come seeking, come hungry, come curious, come open. Come not because you have to, but because you can. Come with all of you. There is room for you here. This is God's table. This is God's meal. You are beloved, so come. Let us pray. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
Lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
God of today, tomorrow, and yesterday, as we begin this new year, we once again find ourselves looking for you. We long for the clarity of the stars in the sky, our voice in the clouds, declaring your presence in our lives. So today, we've asked that you make yourself known to us. Do what only you can do. Reach into our spirits to give us a boost of confidence that love is real and we're not alone. Remind us that we are beloved in your eyes. We know we're asking for a lot for a group that brings very little. We don't have gold or frankincense or myrrh. We haven't thrown off our shoes to honor your holy ground. We haven't been baptized in the Jordan River. We haven't spent the last several days traveling here by camel. We're no Magi, Moses, or Messiah. Yours. Instead, we bring ourselves to the table, to your table, in hopes of catching a glimpse of you. Speak to us in this bread. Speak to us in this cup. Speak to us through these Star Words. Speak speak to us as you spoke through the clouds at Jesus' baptism, so that these star words might be a tool to help us look to you in the coming year. And we remember the night in which Jesus was betrayed and took bread. He gave thanks and he broke it and gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for remembrance of me." And again, after the supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood. It is shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this also for the remembrance of me." And so, God, we thank you and we give you praise. Holy God, you call us beloved. You are with us in our joy. You are with us in our sorrow. Surely, even as we pray, you are with us here as well. So with grateful hearts, we unite our voices together in prayer, using the words that your Son taught us to say, saying together, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." These are the gifts of God for the people of God. A reminder that all are welcome at the Lord's table. Please follow the directions of coming forward to receive the elements down the center aisle and return your seats by the side aisle. And again, pick up your star word for today and for the rest of the year. And we want to thank Giselle and Philip for our special music during the evening.
Life dawns on a weary
Through Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us pray. God of open horizons and open roads, like the Magi many years ago, we are here seeking you. Step by step, we have wandered into this place with the hope of feeling you in our midst. Step by step, you have seen us, claimed us, and calls us beloved. Today we draw star words. For some, these words are full of meaning, challenge, and invitation already. For others, their words are like canvas, inviting you into our lives. So as a new year dawns, we pray, just as you have spoken to the generations before us, you would speak to us again. Allow us to use these star words as a tool that might help us bear and see you more clearly. May they guide us as the star guided the Magi. And in a year, may we find ourselves here together again with mouths full of praise for the ways in which you have been present with us. Together we join with joy in our hearts and we pray. Amen. Receive the blessing. God bless you and keep you. Jesus grant you grace, peace, and truth, and the Spirit send you into your hearts, now and forever.
Amen.
And Marlene, we've got our announcements to make.
Welcome to all, especially guests who are here today. We hope you were blessed by worship. Please join us in the fireside room for refreshments following worship, and you are also invited to join us for Bible study in the boardroom. The men's Bible study meets Tuesday, 9:30 p.m. in the boardroom. All men are invited to this no experience necessary Bible study. The church council meets this Tuesday at 6:30 p.m. in the boardroom. All council members are asked to check their mailboxes by the church office for materials for the meeting. Choir rehearsal is on Wednesday at 10 a.m. Our midweek Bible study meets right after choir at 11 a.m. We will be studying the gospel for next week, the baptism of Jesus. The Dorcas Lydia Circle of the Women's Group meets this Thursday in the boardroom. All women are invited to this special gathering. The Lifestream Blood Bank will be hosting a blood drive here in the fireside room beginning at 1 p.m. Pick up a flyer today and make an appointment. Appointments will help speed up the process. Thank you to Sandy Hopper for the donation of the altar flowers for this morning. Please check the flower chart in the lobby to sign up for future Sundays. Now is the time to get that special day to donate the flowers. Please take your bulletins home with you to mark your calendar for the other events coming up in January, especially the special Epiphany events.
Okay, thank you very much. And one time, I will also be talking about our Epiphany table there. You're invited to bring a candle to light it for someone that you want to honor or remember, especially those people in our lives who were the light of Christ for us. And so we continue to share our lights in that way. And thank you for all of our special music for today. And I invite you to stand as we sing our sending song, Arise, Your Light Has Come.
We have two more announcements. There's a sign-up sheet for family game night that's Saturday the 20th from 4 to 7. And there's also a sign-up sheet for a potluck for the council installation potluck on January 21st. Both sign-ups are on the table in the garden.
Okay, thank you very much. And if you have any questions about that, please sing. Also, Carolyn, it's time, unfortunately, we're going to take down the trees and everything. So if you would like to help Carolyn in any way, Carolyn, just raise your hand and wave. If you'd like to help in any way to undecorate, which is not fine, but that's good, see Carolyn and see if you can help out in some way. Okay, Carolyn, is that okay? Would you like some help?
I'm planning on being here tomorrow. I'm a retired teacher's meeting at 11:30, so I don't know if I can come by 9 or 9:30 where I'll start.
Okay, so if you can help, talk to Carolyn. That'll work. Okay, all right. Okay. Is there anything else, good? Did I miss anything else? I know, Mr. Benson. Okay, good. Now you can stand as you're able, and we'll sing our sentence up and rise your lights up.
Proclaim the good news.
Thanks be to God.